In this video, we will take a look at SyncThing, an alternative to Dropbox or BitTorrent Sync. In this first video, we will have a look on how to download, install and execute SyncThing on Windows. I am now on the homepage of SyncThing. I have to choose the correct version of my operating system. In my case, I'm running a 64-bit Windows system. After the zip file is downloaded, I can open it. I am just interested in the SyncThing.exe file. I navigate to my hard disk and create the folder SyncThing. I move the .exe file from the zip archive in this folder. This is the GitHub page from SyncThing. We can find the start commando there. We copy this command and create a new text file in the SyncThing folder. We paste the string from GitHub page into the text file and save the file as bat file. We can now remove the text file. We are now ready to start SyncThing by double click on the bat file. SyncThing is now starting in the background and we can access the user interface with the web browser. To get the correct port number, we have to go to AppData Local. We just type %AppData% and confirm it with Enter. We can now change to AppData and to the folder Local. We will find a SyncThing folder. In this folder, we open up the config.xml file with a text editor. We are looking for the part which contains the localhost IP and the port number. We can now copy this address in our browser and the web GUI opens up. On the left side we can see the shared folders, on the right side we can see some general information about the system. To start SyncThing at the Windows logon, we open up the task scheduler in Windows. Now we select task scheduler library and make a right click to create a new basic task. The name can be chosen freely. We set the trigger to when I log on. We keep the selection, start a program. In the next step, we browse for the syncthing.bat file, which we created at the beginning. We have to start the script in the folder where the bat and the exe file are located. Now SyncThing will start at Windows logon.